Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1362, Get Hyperlink Link Location. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, we've been talking about hyperlinks this week. Who would think that hyperlinks could have so many different topics? But they do. I'm actually going to switch over to Internet Explorer here, and I'm going to go to a page at my site, www.mrexcel.com/articles.shtml. This is a page I put together a while ago that lists a whole bunch of different articles available out there on the web, not just from my site, from the Tech TV site, from JWalk site, from Chip Pearson site, about 500 different articles out there. And let's just say I'm going to copy this data, Control C to copy, we'll go back to Excel, and paste, Control V. Okay, two very, very annoying things. First of all, they brought all of these little images along. My bank website does this too. It's not the website, it's just the copy and paste, and I need to get rid of those. There used to be a great little arrow down here at the bottom of Excel 2003. It's still here in Excel 2007 or Excel 2010. You need to go to the Home tab, over here to Editing, under Find and Select, and right down at the bottom, there's something called Select Objects. It's a white arrow. And then just draw a box around all of those objects, click Delete, and they're gone. Okay, now here's the real problem. The web page that I copied this from has addresses for all of these articles, but they're kind of hidden underneath the link. We're seeing the friendly name, let's say, instead of the link address, and I really need to get the link address. Wow, this would be tough. Okay, first of all, see, I'm still in Select Objects here, so I need to hit the Escape key. Get out of that. We're going to do a short little macro today. I'm going to press Alt F11, and then we'll go to Insert Module. I love this macro. It's about three lines of code. We're going to say sub get links. You can call that whatever you want, by the way. And we're going to say for each, and I'm going to use a variable here called HL. HL to me stands for hyperlink, in ActiveSheet.hyperlinks. Funny, hyperlinks belong to the worksheet instead of to the individual cells. And we're going to say HL, that's the hyperlink, dot parent, that's the cell that contains the hyperlink. All right, so I'm looking at that cell that contains the hyperlink. I'm going to say dot offset. Offset says we want to move somewhere. I want to move zero rows down, one row to the right. Okay, so that's saying wherever we find a hyperlink, go to the cell immediately to the right of it, and the dot value is going to be equal to hl.address. Remember, hl is the hyperlink, address is a property of the hyperlink, and then just next hl. There we go. And actually, need to go back to Excel. When you use this, make sure that every cell that has a hyperlink has a blank to the right of it. Now this was a blank workbook when I started out, so I know that I'm safe. You might want to insert a new column C there if you have data. All right, let's check this out. I'm switching back to VBA. I just click the Run button there. Bam! It's that fast. Let's look now back in Excel. Oh, sweet. Next to every article title there is now the article URL. All right, so this happens to me a lot. I copied it from a web page. Comes in. I can't see the hyperlinks anymore. I'm not going to go edit each hyperlink to get it out. But a macro will do that very, very, very quickly. Okay, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.